We're given f of x equals the square root of the quantity 2x minus 1 minus 3. We want to determine the domain and range of the given function and then find the inverse function. Because our function contains a square root, in order for the function value to be real, the number underneath the square root or the radicand, which in this case is 2x minus 1, can't be negative, which means 2x minus 1 must be greater than or equal to 0. Since 2x minus 1 must be greater than or equal to 0, this restriction will help us find our domain. We just need to solve this for x. So we'll add 1 to both sides, divide by 2. So x has to be greater than or equal to 1 half, which would be the domain of f of x. If we wanted to use interval notation, this would be the interval from 1 half to infinity, closed on 1 half, meaning it includes 1 half. To find the range of f of x, we want to determine all the possible y values of this function. Well, the value of the square root is always going to be greater than or equal to 0. So the smallest value this could be would be 0 minus 3, which would be negative 3. And all other function values would be larger than negative 3. So the range is y is greater than or equal to negative 3. We're using interval notation. We'd have the interval from negative 3 to infinity. Let's go ahead and verify this by graphing the original function. Again, here's the given function. If we were to project this onto the x-axis, notice how the x values would be from negative 1 half to infinity. And if we projected this onto the y-axis, notice how the values would be from negative 3 to positive infinity. So we have the domain and range correct. Now let's go ahead and find the inverse function. Remember, inverse functions undo each other, meaning if function f has an input of x and an output of y, this y becomes the input into the inverse function, which returns the original value of x. So the process for finding the inverse function is to write this in terms of x and y, and then interchange the x and y variables. So we can write the given function as y equals square root of the quantity 2x minus 1 minus 3, which means the inverse function would be the equation x equals the square root of 2y minus 1 minus 3. And now we just need to solve this for y and replace y with inverse function notation. So the first step, we'll add 3 to both sides of the equation. So we'll have x plus 3 equals the square root of the quantity 2y minus 1. Now to undo the square root, we'll square both sides of the equation. Let's go ahead and leave this as the quantity x plus 3 squared. On the right side, squaring the square root leaves us with the radicand of 2y minus 1. Next step, we'll add 1 to both sides of the equation. That'll give us the quantity x plus 3 squared plus 1 equals 2y. The last step, instead of dividing by 2, let's multiply both sides by 1 half. So on the left side, we'd have 1 half times the quantity x plus 3 squared plus 1 equals, on the right side, we just have y. Now we could multiply this out and try to simplify this, but I'm going to go ahead and leave it in this form. But we should replace y with inverse function notation. So f inverse of x is equal to 1 half times the quantity x plus 3 squared plus 1. Now it's important to remember the domain of this inverse function is restricted. It's going to be the range of the original function. So let's go ahead and list that. The domain of this function is going to be when x is greater than or equal to negative 3, or the interval from negative 3 to infinity. Again, remember, the output of the original function becomes the input into the inverse function. So the range of f is the domain of f inverse. And the range of the inverse function will be the domain of the original function. So our domain is going to be y greater than or equal to 1 half, which using interval notation would be from 1 half, closed on 1 half, to positive infinity. So here's the domain of the original function. Here's our inverse function and the domain and range of the inverse function. The last step, I always like to verify this graphically. Remember, if we graph the function and its inverse function on the same coordinate plane, the two functions should be symmetrical across the line y equals x. Here's the graph of the original function, our square root function. And here's the graph of our quadratic function, or the inverse function. And notice how the domain of the inverse function has been restricted due to the range of the original function. And here's the line y equals x. And notice how the two graphs are symmetrical across this line. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.